When the sun shines, you want to be outside, and cooking outdoors is a joy. Whether you're going to a festival, camping, or just having a barbecue in your own back garden.
The best thing about being outside and food is just the whole social aspect, you know, cooking outside, picnics, sharing stuff about kids, families. I just love it. It's not just about cooking a sausage on a barbecue, do you know what I mean? There's so much you can do.
I'm going to show you a handful of incredible recipes that are amazing to cook in the great outdoors.
We don't have summer for very long in Britain, and when the sun does shine, you've got to make use of it. And I want to show you how to cook some things that are going to blow your mind.
The summer's all about getting away with friends and family, and that time is precious. So here's a dish that you can prepare while you're packing to leave. It's an amazing chili con carne, but not as you know it. This one's got proper texture because instead of mince, I'm using a delicious piece of beef brisket.
Let's kick off with a nice little tip about trying to create a portable hot meal that will last about 3-4 hours in the back of a car. So when you get somewhere, whether it's camping or a festival or no matter what, it's hot and delicious, and you don't have to just rely on dodgy old things from like a service station. We've got a nice bit of beef brisket, about 1.5 kilo. Score about 1.5 centimetres down your brisket. We're creating a little chessboard here to rub in some flavours and seasoning.
Cover liberally with salt and pepper. Then throw about a level tablespoon of ground cumin and grab a tin of smoked paprika.
Now you can either take the lid off like this or get a blunt knife and just stab it. Kind of means that you've created like a little shaker. You want about a tablespoon level of this paprika. It's smoky, it's got a bit of heat to it, it's delicious, it's going to give real attitude straight away. And then some oregano, about a tablespoon again. Rub that into all the little cracks. And you see how it's all sticking to the meat like that. And then we've got a pan on a medium heat, a little bit of olive oil, and go straight in with our brisket here. That'll toast up the spices. We'll start crisping up the outside of the brisket to kind of, you know, give some attitude to the stew.
Any leftover spice goes in the pot along with a couple of tins of tomatoes and one tin of beef stock. Then grab a couple of red and yellow peppers.
Just push in the stalk here so it goes in, and then you can pull it out like that and you don't have to waste any.
Chop them up and chuck them in the pot with a stick of cinnamon.
A couple of bay leaves never hurt, and just whack that on the heat over here on full whack. Look at that. It's like a corrugated wall of sizzling meat.
Move the brisket from the pan to the pot. Then slice up a couple of onions, 4 cloves of garlic, and then some chilies to spice things up a little bit. 2 to 4 will be brilliant. Add all of this to the pan with the brisket juices.
The room will start filling with incredible flavours. There's some chili in there for sure.
When the onions are softened, add this to the pot.
Push that beef right into the bottom of that pan. Grab a little bit of coriander. This will be incredible. Now it's come to the boil, just put the lid on, turn it down to really low, and let it simmer for about 4-4.5 hours, and it will be delicious.
Giving you plenty of time to go and pack. So when you're ready to go, you can make the chili con carne portable by wrapping it up like a present, and that'll keep it nice and toasty. First, seal it with cling film, and then cover it with foil.
You kind of go around the outside as well.
Now, for extra insulation, grab whatever's to hand. I've got a couple of tea towels and a picnic blanket.
When everyone else is eating some dodgy old scrotum burger or a dodgy service station snack, we have got the incredible chili con carne, my style.
You pour portable chili brisket is going to stay nice and hot for a good few hours and get better and better with time. The best part is that you've got a great meal ready to go the moment that you arrive.
I'm going to bring this beautiful pulled brisket chili back to life. Do a nice little guacamole. Got a few beers. I mean, the nice thing is, like, even though it was nearly cooked when I put it in the pan, it's carried on cooking and it's just got better and better. Oh, it's still hot. It's got a nice kick to it. Now, look at this delicious meat. It's just literally gravity's making it fall apart if I just use my fingers. Look, can you see how wonderful it's just pulling apart? And that's the whole thing with a pulled brisket. For me, the joy of a good chili is not mincemeat. I want it to have texture. Oh.
Because this dish has been traveling for a couple of hours, I'm gonna freshen it up with a splash of vinegar and a touch of salt.
Coriander, and then that's good to go. That really is very good to go. Nice one.
Now, the perfect partner to our chili brisket has got to be a handmade guacamole with loads of lime. Just get stuck in with some clean hands.
You don't need a knife, you don't need a machine, right? You do need ripe avocados for sure, because I truly believe that this makes the best guacamole. I'm going to squeeze it in my hand like this, right? Just squash it up in your hand. Look at the colour of that, beautiful. Get yourself some coriander and just twist it. Look, I'm doing this in the most crude possible way. I mean, at the end of the day, big man upstairs gave you a pair of hands. You might as well bleed and use them, do you know what I mean? The only thing I'm going to use is my onion. Just a rubbishy old grater. Half a red onion gone in there. And then we want to go heavy on the lime, heavy. To be fresh, to be summertime, you know, to cut through roasted or grilled meats and stuff like that. So just get that lime in there.
Season with salt, pepper, and then grab some joyfully ripe tomatoes and squeeze right through your hands.
Just scrunch it. As long as your hands are clean, you know, you got them, they're there for free, you don't have to plug them in.
Finally, mix in some grated chili and you're ready.
That will make the world of difference. You're right, guys. If you pull out all the seats and stuff, I am pretty much ready to go as far as I can work out.
Now you can serve up your handmade guacamole with your brisket, add some simple lettuce leaves, some yogurt, and some soft tortillas. Nice.
Oh, George, you just nearly stitched me up. Oh, look at that.
Coming up next, I'm going to show you some more amazing outdoor recipes like bucket smoked fish, easy pancake cake, and spatchcock chicken. I'm celebrating the Great British Summer in the way that I know how to, by cooking up a storm with some of my favourite outdoor recipes. Eating outdoors doesn't have to mean takeaway sandwiches and burnt barbecue meat. I want to show you that whether you're rural rambling or back garden barbecuing, you can always enjoy great food wherever you are. For me, eating in the open air is all about fire and smoke, and there's nothing that hits the taste buds better than hot smoked fish. And the great thing about this dish is it's so simple to make. Imagine pulling a dish like this out of the bag for your mates over a campfire. It'll blow them away.
What I'm going to do is proper sort of Cub Scout stuff, even though I got kicked out of the Scouts. Don't worry about that. Don't judge me on that. You can go and buy a smoker, but I don't want you to go and buy a smoker because, to be honest, all you need is a bucket. And in my life, I am surrounded by buckets. Right, so we put holes in the bottom for airflow. Very, very simple. Every house needs one. Every man needs one of these.
So fill a bucket with about 3 inches of white hot charcoal from the barbecue.
Then I've got some wood chips here, which you can buy, you know, from garden centres and stuff like that, or get a penknife and just do a pile of splinters. You want to use things like oak, apple, cherry woods. You don't want anything oily like pine. You can see the smoke coming off it now, dead simple. Over here, I've got some prawns and trout. Okay, so first of all, I've just got some nice big prawns. I've taken the shell off. Let me show you how to do one. Hold the head, just crack off the body shell, pull that off, and go right down and leave the tail fin on, just because it looks quite cool and it's good to hold onto. So peel that off like that, and then skewer it. And then just lay these, just like that. Then I want you to get a load of skewers, wooden, everyday skewers. You can use metal ones if you want, and just lay it across, almost like a game of kiplonk, right? Crisscross like that. Then I've got some trout fillets, everyday trout fillets here. You could use salmon. Some seasoning. We could even get some lemon zest if you want, just give it some freshness and some brightness. And then I'm gonna lay that trout over the kiplonk. Flesh side down, and the smoke will come around and it will kiss the fish. And then all you have to do is get a wet cloth. I'm just gonna lay it over the top like that. And that means it's holding all the smoke in. So that bucket now is just full of like foggy smoke.
And it's only gonna take about 5 to 7 minutes to cook. With that smoky, silky fish, I wanna make a punchy dressing. So it's 50-50 horseradish sauce to yogurt and a good pinch of salt and pepper and a squeeze of lemon.
I just think this is exciting, you know. As a dad of a little boy now, I can't wait to teach little buddy how to do this. I love the fact that, you know, if you teach your kid to do it, he'll probably do it with his kids. And I just love, love, love all that sort of stuff. So look, I'm really pleased with that. Got me sauce done. I got me smoker on. Yeah, I'm gonna make a lovely little salad. Finely slice some onion, okay?
Season with salt and a nice squeeze of lemon. Then massage it all over to take the heat out of the onion. Get some watercress and some good old-fashioned cress and dress with a little olive oil. Job done.
Then we come to our fish. Right, these would be done by now. I pretty much know when fish is cooked, when you can pull the skin off. Look at that. Let's pick up this fillet. I'm gonna let gravity flake it. Just let it bust. Cooked in its own juices. It's such an intelligent way to cook. And then look, what's quite interesting is all the heads did fall off with your head, right? But what's quite lovely is the flavor of prawns is in the head, right? So as the head falls on the charcoals, right, all of the oils from the shell and the flavor turns into smoke. Do you know what I mean? You're just sort of atomizing brains. Yeah. That's what all this is about.
Just dress it with a little lemon juice. And of course, olive oil.
I love the little dream of going away with the family with an old fire bucket, you know, full of a few little things to do this. Imagine, and like, you know, picnic, but not as you know it. For me, that's what this kind of summer festival food season is all about. Do you know what I mean? It's about the unexpected. It's about bigging it up. It's about surprising yourself with things you can do. So there you go. Beautiful smoked fish, prawns, trout, horseradish sauce, and a lovely little watercress and onion salad. Happy days. Bang it in your gob. Absolutely gorgeous.
Now, who'd have thought that you could make a cake in the garden, especially without an oven? But me and my little helpers are gonna show you just how to do it. And the best part, they can make as much mess as they like.
We've got the simplest recipe that anyone can make, anyone. So can I have a volunteer, please? I want one person to hold a cup. Come forward, my little darling. I need someone to hold a bowl. Joel, if you just take that bowl, my darling. I need you to put
3 cups right up to the top of self-raising flour. Sir, can you pour that for me? Now, this is what you call slave labour. Lovely, get the kids working. Now, next, I need another helper.